Hey, how are you? Did you go and visit with her?
No, I didn't.
Oh. Y'all, at some point, y'all are going to have a nice visit.
That's what I was going to do.
Well, Dilly, here's the thing. From here on out, let me bring up all the necessary things. And you need to just get back on the friendship level with her, because you've been the, you know, kind of the heavy on things and getting her. I'm looking at it from this perception.
You understand what you're saying.
Yeah, and you. Dilly, I told you that I will fucking write the check. I will write it and send it to him and get her to sign it. She will pay these people. She's going to pay them. There's no two ways about it. That's just business. And she's got to do it. Okay, well, from now on, let me do... So you can get back on that friendship plane with her. You moved her from her home. She's associating that, I think, subconsciously. And yes, exactly. So let's cool the jets on your being the boss, and let me take over for a bit and let her be mad at me. It's okay. Oh, I will. I'll keep you in the loop all the way around. Yes, I will. No problem. And if I have to write the check, I have power of attorney, and I'll sign it off to it. That's fine. That's no problem. But she is, Dilly, I know she has the money. I will get her to sign the check. She's going to fucking write it. She's going to write it out. Because she's crazy as hell, Billy. She's crazy. That's why. That's the only reason why. Good luck. Why, Dilly? They're taking... Dilly, if that's on her, Dilly. What would she be doing at home? That's what she fucking did at the house.
I told her she can't go back and do that. She's not safe.
Right, exactly. So this is... Don't... Look. You get a stiff upper lip and don't... We're not changing fucking course here. We're not doing it.
Well, we don't have another course to take.
Right. Exactly. We're not going to feel sorry for her because she doesn't want to participate. That's her own dry drunk self. That's her. All the way. And she said that they had people come down and get her and everything to go to the meal hall, and they were having sausage, and she said she couldn't eat that, and so they brought her some. Yeah, so look, she's just boudin, Dilly. Let her boudin all she wants. We're gonna take control now. If she doesn't want to do it, then somebody's got to.
And well, see, she accepts control. That's the problem. She accepts control from you, but I've never tried to control her.
Well, you moved, you got her out of her house. That was a huge undertaking right there. I mean, and I told her, I said, You're not going back to Lafayette. You're not going back to your home. I'm sorry. She's got to process all this, and it's going to take some time, but she will write that check. She will do it. All right. I'm going to call her right now. I'm
Well,
that's okay. Go see her tomorrow.
I'm not going to see her tomorrow unless she asks me to. I have to go see my patient.
Oh, okay. Well, then take some time off. Let her sit there and lament all she wants. But I will get up there.
I can still go see her in the early morning, or I can go see her late in the afternoon.
Dilly, you don't have to go see her every day. Take a break. Take a break from her. Yeah, because somebody... That's bullshit, Dilly. I looked in her closet. She's got...
She won't wear those clothes.
Oh, my God in heaven.
I know. All she wants to do is wear a white blouse and those pants. I bought her another pair of sweatpants. I bought her, like, four pairs of sweatpants.
Okay. Well... Well, she'll wear the same shit, and then whenever I go to Lafayette, I'll bring some more of her stuff. But look, we got to play hardball with her now. If she's acting the way she's acting towards you, take a break from her. Be her friend for a little bit, and I'll be the heavy.
Okay.
All right? All right. I will get over there on, I get out of work at 1:30 tomorrow. I can head that way. Well, I have a job interview at Bass Pro Shop for this travel agency. I don't know if they're selling timeshares or what the hell it is, but I will.
Okay. But after that, you can go?
Well, no, because I have a game in the afternoon, but I will get up. I'm going to call her right now. And she's gonna write the check. I'm gonna get a guarantee out of her.
That, well, you've given your guarantees before.
Well, that's okay. That's all right. I'll bring that up and say, hey, look, you promised you would write the check, and why hasn't the check been written? Why hasn't it been written? Why? I will. All right, let me call her up and see what she's doing. Bye. Hello, my sweet little mama.
Hey, fella, what are you doing?
I'm at a baseball game,
waiting to video it or what?
Yes, ma'am. What are you doing? You're about to go to the dining hall?
No, I'm not going down there today because I didn't feel good today.
Uh-oh, what's the matter?
It was not a good day, but I can go somewhere to get something to eat.
Well, how are you going to get there, baby?
Well, I'm waiting for some wheels.
Well, you got your wheelchair.
I don't have anything that can get me anywhere.
Well, did they bring you your supper?
No. They came down and gave me to go, and I said, I just can't make it today. I had real, real bad diarrhea this morning.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, but it's not anything worse than usual.
Did you have an accident?
No, I didn't have an accident.
Oh, good deal. You made it to the potty then?
Yeah.
Oh, boy. Okay.
Everything was all right.
All right. Good. Good. Well, other than that, how you kind of...
Other than that, anytime you feel like getting something to eat, just come by here and raid the refrigerator.
Well, are they going to bring you supper tonight?
Yeah, they're bringing it. It's here.
Oh,
it's
okay.
Here. All I have to do is walk down to my private dining room and eat it.
Where are you right now?
Huh?
Where are you right now?
In my swanky bedroom.
All right, baby. Good deal. Good deal.
I'm doing better, fella. But I just didn't feel like I couldn't go down there today. And I had that bad swell this morning, and I couldn't do it.
More.
So when I told her, I just can't make it down there.
Okay. Well, they understand.
What do you say? I'm bringing your lunch up here.
Yeah, there you go. Good. Well, make sure you eat it, okay?
I'll eat it unless you're going to come by here to eat it.
No, I can't make it up there tonight. I'm at a baseball game.
Well, good.
And
I
won't get out of here until probably almost 7:30, 8 o'clock. And then I'm going to go to a meeting after I picked up 90 Day Chip yesterday.
You did? Did people see you pick that up?
Yep. Mm-hmm. I picked it up in a meeting.
I'm proud of you, fella. That's all I can say is I am very proud of you for doing all of that.
Well, thank you, Mom. I'm happy too.
That's good. Good, good.
Yeah, I've been very busy. Went to work and now I'm at this game, and I'm going to go to a meeting tonight and then go get in the bed and wake up at 4:30 in the morning. I'm sleeping at the apartment all week this week because Jennifer does not want to see me. But I am going to go get Ella from the... I'm going to wake her up in the morning and get her on the bus. My boss already cleared that. I can break away and go and do that. So.
Well, you... It says it's all right if you break away and do that.
Yeah. Yeah. So, I'm going to go get Ella on the bus. I'm going to call the kids, get them up for... school, make sure they're up. They usually wake up anyway, so everything's good there.
Well, that's good.
Because Jennifer works tomorrow, and she said she doesn't want me around whenever she's at the house. So.
Well, that's good.
Oh, yeah. That's okay.
I mean, well, keep it like that for a while.
Yeah.
What's wrong with that?
Yeah, that's right. That's fine. I'll honor that request. No problem. No problem at all.
Good.
Hey.
I had a strange phone call today.
From who?
From somebody called in saying that they were representing a party that is complaining that they are mistreating their loved ones.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. They're mistreating their family.
And what'd you tell them?
I said, well, you sure have it right here, baby.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
Well, I told them, well, no one here is doing that, and I don't know what to tell you. I've been moved from a flatbed over here
But that was on my own.
That was on your own decision.
Yeah, I should have just referred the call to Dilly.
No, you can answer your own fucking, your own business.
Yeah.
Speaking of business, we need to talk about a little business. Have you written the check yet for the facility?
I have not, and I don't feel bad about it. I'm going to write it tomorrow and take it down there. And Dilly thoroughly discussed it with me that I didn't do it today.
Don't renege on doing it tomorrow then. I'm holding you to it, right? You're going to do it?
I'm going to do it tomorrow.
Okay.
But why go down there looking like death rolled over?
When do you go to the beauty parlor?
I was trying to get in there today, but I couldn't go anywhere today.
Well, you'll feel better tomorrow. All right. Well, do me a favor. Can you...
If you're going to tell me to take another one of those Corona
shots, no, I'm going to tell you to...
I go down with that disease before I take another one of those.
Amen to that. Do me a favor and call me after you give the people the check.
I will try to do that.
But look...
Don't hold me to it.
I won't hold you to calling, but I'm holding you to writing the check and delivering it to him tomorrow.
That is very good.
And
I can
certainly do that. Mom, this is a promise. You're going to do it, right?
Yeah, I'm going to do it tomorrow.
Okay, good deal.
I'm sorry, I can't do everything Dilly tells me to do.
That's fine. Look, Dilly's just, she's working in your best interest. The reason...
She is, I know she is, and I respect everything she does. But look, I can do something on my own.
Well, by God, then whenever you say you're going to do it, do it. And she said, here's the thing. Dilly told me whenever she talked to the insurance people who are paying you back for this thing, that the longer you take to write the facility the check, the facility then can't send the insurance people the invoice so they can release your money to you. So the quicker you pay the facility in the month, the quicker you're gonna get reimbursed.
Okay, I will do that, but if you don't mind too terribly much, could I call the good banker who helps me out down there and find out if everything is cleared for me to write the check?
No problem, but don't let that delay you from writing the check, because we all know you have the money to clear it a thousand times over.
I don't know about that, though.
Mom, I'm telling you, I've seen your balance in the account.
Okay, I will do that. I will certainly do it.
All right, thank you very much, Mom. I love you. And did you get any, you didn't go anywhere, you just stayed in that apartment all day?
Yes, I did, and I thoroughly enjoyed it.
You didn't get a puzzle to go?
When it comes to me working those puzzles,
you'd have puzzle pieces all over the fucking place.
I sure would. I would take it and cram it.
I know, you never have been a big puzzle person, but you are a good card player.
Well, I'd rather be a card player than putting those puzzles together. I like cards now. Don't get me wrong, I love cards.
Who are you talking to?
I'm talking to myself, to you on
the phone. I already know you like cards.
Whenever you get a spare night, come back here and I'll be surprised.
It'll be this weekend.
Oh, you won't be by here this weekend.
It might be Saturday night.
You think you're going to do that?
Yeah. Well, you know, Miss Ella's birthday is coming up on the 9th. She's gonna be 11 on the 9th.
She can't be 11.
Yep.
She's gonna be getting bosoms before long.
I know.
Oh, good grief.
Oh, my God.
She's still the cutest thing ever walking.
I know, huh? She's adorable. Yeah. Well, look, Mom, this ball game's about to start. I gotta get focused.
Well, look, you get focused and enjoy what you're doing because you're a champion at it, all right?
I love it, Mom.
I love you, fella. And hang in there with what you're doing. Don't let anyone cut you down.
All right, baby. I won't.
Okay.
All right.
Love you.
I'll call
Bye-bye.
You tomorrow. All right.
Good.
Hey.
I'm sorry. I was in the other room. I couldn't get up here quick
enough. That's all right. Hey, I talked to her. Her spirits are better now, but she said she's going to write the check tomorrow. We'll see. She said she would write it and deliver it herself. So, don't go over there tomorrow. What you can do is, if you want to, you could call the people and let them know that she's told us that she's going to deliver the check to you, to them, tomorrow.
Okay.
Or in the morning, you know, let them know that please expect the check. My mother's going to deliver it. And if they don't, if she doesn't, don't go over there tomorrow. Let her be. Let her sit there. Do not go over there tomorrow. Please.
Okay.
She didn't say anything, but we had a good talk. I want to see if she's going to do it.
Did she say she had an argument with me?
She said you were thoroughly disgusted with her.
Well, I didn't tell
her
that, but I kind of am.
Yep, she knows you, Jilly.
Yeah.
And she knows how to push your buttons.
Oh, boy, does she know how to do that. You are absolutely 100% right.
Yep.
Okay, well, thanks for talking to her.
All right, and call them as early as you can. Or I'll call them if you want me to. I don't know who the lady is that you talk
well,
with.
You need to talk. I have to talk to. I don't know which one you talk to.
Administration?
But I think the main person I would call. I was going to call us and talk to Ada. Just call the main number and ask for Ada, the director of nurses.
Please text me that information.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. All right. Bye.
top of all your face.
Yep.
Come on, man. That's right, Eddie.
Go get him. Go get him.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
All Thank you.
Patrick.com.
Thank you.
right, be ready. Come on.
Thank you.
Shake it off, come on.
Here, Big O. Here, Big O.
Thank you. I Thank you. Yeah.
be ready. Come on.
Run it. Come on.
strikes, Carson, that's it. Carson.
Thank you.
guy. Come on. All right, Dylan, come on. You got it. Great swing. Let's do it again. Jace. Come on. job, Dylan. Good job, Dylan.
Way to go, Dylan. Great forward.
Hey, Aunt Liz. How are you?
Good job.
Yeah, good. Good. Well, you're not as old as my mama, at least.
Well, I know she's got a few years older than me, but I'm coming down the pike pretty fast.
Ah, you're doing good, Aunt Liz.
How is your mom?
She's doing okay, I guess. Yeah, we got her in this assisted living place, and it's real nice. But she just misses my dad so bad.
Yeah.
It's hard on me.
And it's hard on you because you're witnessing it.
Yeah, it's kind of depressing. Yeah. But I figured I'd give you a shout and see how you're doing. No, she's like Richard Gere from The Officer and the Gentleman. She's got no place else to go. That's it. That's what we don't. Well, my guy's over there. He cuts the grass, but I'm gonna. We're going to have to put that place up for sale. You know?
I mean, it's paying the cost of where she is. I'm sure it's very expensive.
Well, Ann Liz, she really did good. She got an insurance policy to cover that. So.
Oh, my goodness.
She did great.
That's wonderful.
But then she, you know your sister and the way she is. She has her... Y'all had the same mother, and y'all act a little... She acts a lot like Memo sometimes. So... I don't have a whole lot of time. I'm at a baseball game for work, but the game just wrapped up. I wanted to just
say I'm thinking of you, and we're hanging in there. Well, give him a big hug for me, and I love you, and hopefully we'll see each other at some time in the near future. I don't know.
Yeah. I don't either, but listen, I love you, and thank you so much for calling me. You don't know how much it means to me, because I can't call your mother. I have no idea. I get about it. She won't answer my call anyhow, even if she has a phone, so I'm stuck. And you and Dilly are the only ones I have to get any communication.
All right, I love you, Ann Wiz. Tell,
I love
you. Tell all my cousins I said hello.
Oh, they'll be happy to hear from you. I guarantee you. Okay, I will.
All right, I love you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.